Hello, my name is David Faure and I work for KDAB. Welcome to part 2 of the series GammaRay for Qt Widgets applications. In this video, you are going to see how to identify widgets in an application you don't know and how to find where in the code those widgets are created. Right, the application I'm going to use for this is KWrite from KDE. Imagine you launch KWrite, you do Control R for find and replace, and then you're wondering what is the name of that widget and where does it come from. Obviously, we can't do that from just a running application, so what we are going to do instead is close it and run it in GammaRay. I simply have to type GammaRay KWrite, and then KWrite is starting in GammaRay. Now the application is running as usual, but I also see a new window which is from GammaRay, and it shows a preview of the KWrite window in there. What we can do now is use Control R to show the find and replace widget again. And if you do Control Shift click on it, then it will select that widget in GammaRay. In the tree here, we can see that the widget is called Kate Search Bar. Aha, we have found the class name. Now the next question was, where in the code is it created? So to do that, we can use the fact that GammaRay has recorded a stack trace of the creation of every object. So if we go to the stack trace tab, we will be able to see where in the code it was created. All right, we see here the constructor, Kate Search Bar. We also see Kate UBar widget, that is just a base class. So if we're interested in the code that did the creation of Kate Search Bar, we go one level up here, right-click Show Source, and then it will open the source code that is mentioned here directly in our preferred editor. You can choose that editor in the Settings menu, Code Navigation, and then you can, in my case, I selected Qt Creator, you can pick whichever one you want. All right, so we have managed to open the code in Qt Creator, which is here, and we can see that new Kate search bar is actually here on line 165. So this is where the widget is created. This is very convenient in a code base you don't know, because instead of reading 10 million lines of code, you can easily use GammaRay to pinpoint the creation of the widget, and maybe you can go from there to investigate a bug and things like that. Thank you for watching this tutorial. I hope you enjoyed it, and see you in part 3 in the next video.